is a pure, plentiful natural resource.
Right now, wind is in high demand.
And it holds the potential to transform the way we power our homes and businesses.
It's changing the way power is being made in the country. It's really having an impact.
The National Renewable Energy Laboratory is at the forefront of wind energy research and development. NREL's National Wind Technology Center near Boulder, Colorado is a world-class facility dedicated to accelerating and deploying wind technology.
It's great to be working in a job and surrounded by people who are passionate and know that what they're doing is making the world a better place.
And NREL is leading by example. A 1 megawatt photovoltaic array complements the turbines to offset the site's power consumption.
At this point, the wind center generates over half of the entire energy needs for all of NREL. On a day when it's windy and it's sunny, we are putting a lot of power onto the local utility grid.
The National Wind Technology Center is located where wind funneled through El Dorado Canyon spills onto the plains, an ideal test site.
We'll have many days in the winter with winds over 50, 60 miles an hour, and often a handful of days with winds of 90, 100 miles an hour. That makes it a really excellent site for understanding the full range of operating conditions these wind turbines have to withstand.
The extreme conditions here allow NREL and its industry partners to ensure these machines deliver in any environment. They're testing a range of turbines from smaller residential sizes to the Siemens utility scale 2.3 megawatt machine,
which is a real giant. It has a rotor diameter of over 100 meters.
This wind turbine is one of the largest now operating in the United States. It's providing critical information on aerodynamics and load capabilities, and it's one of two massive new turbines added to the site in 2009. The second is a General Electric 1.5 megawatt machine owned by the Department of Energy.
Every time I try to guess where the maximum size of a machine will be, I'm always wrong. It keeps growing and growing.
The towers are taller to tap into the higher winds at greater altitudes. These machines are more powerful, they produce more energy, and they have to perform.
Although it looks like the machines are operating at a graceful, steady pace, the reality of the wind environment that they're having to endure is quite turbulent and very unsteady.
This is the control room for the dynamometer test facilities.
This is the world's first test facility for wind turbine drivetrains.
So we're simulating the wind mechanically.
A controlled laboratory environment where industry partners evaluate their prototypes.
What's neat about that is that we don't have to wait for the wind to blow, or we don't have to wait for the right conditions to be able to do the testing.
To create energy, the wind turns the blades, which rotate the shaft. The gearbox in the drivetrain then converts that wind into power.
The drivetrain consists of this main shaft, the gearbox, the generator, and then the system that converts that electricity back onto the grid.
Each component must function flawlessly.
This is what we call the industrial user facility. It's designed to be able to do wind turbine blade testing.
The turbine blades are also put through punishing trials. They are bent.
And the tip is nearly touching the floor and almost touching the ceiling when it's deflecting.
Even broken.
We test those both for static strength and for fatigue strength.
Here, the 20-year lifespan of a turbine is tested in months.
We're one of maybe four or five labs in the world that can do this, the only one in the United States.
The National Wind Technology Center is a global resource for making sure these machines are reliable, then helping move them to the marketplace.
Right now, wind is the technology that's being deployed at a scale and a scope that's really making a difference in our nation's power generation.
Wind makes up 3% of all power generated in this country and rising. The goal is 20% by the year 2030. We're on track to meet that goal 5 years ahead of schedule. The next frontier is offshore. It's already a reality in Europe.
When we look at the potential for offshore, it's enormous.
And there's so much available wind resource there. There's enough to more than enough to supply electricity for the country.
28 states border a coast.
Inside those 28 states, we use 78% of the electricity in the nation.
You can potentially site the wind turbines far enough offshore that they don't create a visual impact, but are still close enough that the transmission problem is greatly alleviated.
Wind is an essential element in shaping a secure, sustainable energy future. Wind turbines throughout the United States are generating new revenues for landowners and boosting local economies.
They're bringing jobs, they're bringing good jobs, they're bringing sustainable jobs.
The National Wind Technology Center is developing and delivering the advancements to optimize wind energy production, minimize impacts on wildlife, and provide it at an affordable cost.
The goal is to really make wind-generated electricity kind of the cheapest form of energy on the planet.
Right now, wind energy is pretty competitive with conventional sources, but if we can continue to lower the cost of wind energy, we'll get to a situation where it could potentially be the lowest cost source of energy in the nation, and that will be transformative.
Wind, it is power and progress. The National Renewable Energy Laboratory is innovating the clean technologies to forever change our energy landscape.
It's really a great challenge, it's been a great challenge, and it's a great joy to see it going out and being used.